Raytheon's RF foundry in Andover, Massachusetts. We design and fabricate the world's most advanced semiconductors that allow Raytheon systems and radars to operate the best in the world. There's no compromise in performance for our military systems. That means we engineer everything down to the atomic level with our gallium nitride devices. And then we can package that and integrate that so that our subsystems and ultimately our radars are also optimized for the best cost and performance possible. Gallium nitride in general offers a 3 to 5 times better performance than the gallium arsenide technology. The easiest thing to understand is you could offer further range. You could also create a smaller radar with the same performance, and that translates into lower weight or less costs, which is important for, you know, airborne systems. How do we go and get more power per element out of our systems to offer just new breakthrough performances?
We start with a semiconductor wafer. That really is the technology that provides the performance. We are growing a semiconductor material. We're actually growing a gallium with a nitrogen atom to create our gallium nitride. We have multiple machines here that will get us down to the atomic level. One is the molecular beam epitaxy. It basically takes the pure elements, whether it's gallium, nitrogen, aluminum that we have, and those pure elements are heated up to very high temperatures, and we're growing atom by atom on the wafer. The electron beam lithography tool takes an energized electron beam and defines the size of our transistors, and that is really the transistor's heart of our chips, and that determines what we get for electrical performance. If you take a human hair is like 50 microns. We are operating at about 0.25 micron is our transistor. Never mind at the atomic level where it's one gallium atom. Once we complete one of the wafers at the foundry, we basically singulate them into individual chips. And those chips go next door to get assembled into the RF heads or the transmit and receive modules.
I build the first somewhere between 1 and 100 pieces of every new RF module design that we make. We'll build the first pieces of it, and then within somewhere between 12 and 30 months, they'll be in production next door in the factory. Most of the stuff that we make here, the magic is in the inner layers of the circuit board, because that's where the RF circuitry is. But a circuit board, as you look at it, could have as many as 20 or 30 layers inside it. You can have a board that's maybe 4 to 6 inches square with 800 components on both sides of it. You know, as the density increases, the component size drops, and they become increasingly more difficult to make. As a design organization, you can take a spec that's flowed down from a customer and look at it and say, well, what's the most efficient way of doing this? All of that kind of means quicker time to market.
Raytheon's Advanced Technology Group develops braking technology that closes gaps on our warfighters' needs to go off and win future missions and provide future capabilities that are necessary to win the fight. It's a really incredible feeling when you know that your work is making a difference for the United States or across the globe. It's a very empowering experience, and one that I cherish with this role.